Hi, and welcome to Run Tall with Tim. I'm Tim. Thanks for being here. I always appreciate the time that you and I get to spend together, so thanks for tuning in. On today's video, I'm going to be reviewing a flip belt by Nathan. It's called their Zipster Lite. This is a step-through flip belt, and with a name like Zipster Lite, it makes you wonder, well, just how lightweight is it, and is it light on performance? So that's what we're going to be talking about today. But before I get into it too far, I always like to demonstrate the products I'm about to review for you. So let's do that. I'm going to head out to my state park. I'm going to step through and slip this on and take it for a run. But then when I get back, we're going to take a real close look at the different features and the performance of the Nathan Zipster Lite. I did purchase this with my own money. It costs $30. I've had mine for a couple of months now. The reason I purchased mine is I was looking for a way to carry my cell phone during a 5K race that I ran, the Turkey Trot, and I was hoping to find something that was going to be a little bit more comfortable than what I had. Oh, and before I go too far, I do want to take this opportunity to invite you to join the Run Tall family by subscribing to the channel. Now, I post running shoe reviews, comparisons, and shoe battles weekly, but I also like to post other videos about running as well, like this one. So if you enjoy watching running shoe reviews and other videos about running, be sure to subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to click the notification bell so that you'll be notified each time that I upload new content. Okay, back to the Zipster Lite. Now, it does live up to its name. On my scales, it came in at just 2.2 ounces or 61 grams, and that's for a size small. Now, because this is a step-through training belt, there aren't any adjustable straps or cords to get a customized fit, so it's important that you order the right size. Now, I followed their sizing chart, and it worked out great for me. It does have a bit of stretch to it, primarily on the sides here, the side panels, and you can see there's a bit of stretch there. The material itself, it's about 89% nylon and about 11% spandex. But again, there aren't any adjustments here, so you're going to be relying on a stretch of the material to get that customized fit. It worked out perfect for me, so I just encourage you to use that sizing chart that they provide for you. Now, this training belt does feature four different storage pockets. It has two weather-resistant pockets that both have zippers, and then two side pockets that are made of a mesh material. So let's take a closer look at each one. So let's start with the front pocket first. Now, this is a zippered, weather-resistant pocket, so it's perfect for your cell phone. It is large enough to accommodate some of the plus-size phones that are out there, but maybe not the largest of the large phones because they're making them pretty big now. For demonstration purposes and to give you an idea, I was using an old iPhone Plus that I had laying around because it is a larger phone, and it does fit in that pocket pretty snugly. Now, this also has a port that you can run a cord through for some corded earbuds. Most cell phones out today don't have a place for that earphone jack to be plugged in anymore because they went to Bluetooth. But if you have an older phone or if you have a device that you want to use and carry in that pocket, you do have that port that you can run the cord through to make it a little bit more convenient for you. So let's take a look at pockets 2 and 3. Now, these are the side mesh pockets. And again, these are not weather resistant, but it does help keep the weight down. Plus, it helps the belt to run just a little bit cooler on those hot days. Now, this is an area where, or a place where I like to store the things that I want to get to quickly. And you can see that it just folds in onto itself. So again, there's no zipper, but it's a great place to put things like your nutrition bars, maybe some gel, something along those lines. Again, something that you just want to have really easy access to. And then that brings us to the fourth pocket, which is located in the back of the training belt. This is another weather-resistant pocket with a zipper, so it's a great place to keep the kinds of things that you really can't afford to lose. And in my case, this is where I like to keep my key fob. Overall, I think this is a really comfortable, lightweight training belt. Lots of storage in this little belt. You got plenty of places for you to be able to carry your cell phone, car keys, credit cards, maybe a little cash in case you need to stop and get a drink. $30 price tag, I think it's a little bit high, but be on the lookout for some sales. As of the making of this video, I was checking on the prices, and you can find this exact same belt, black, small, for just about $7, $6.99 on Amazon here in the US. So it's definitely worth shopping around. Hey, thanks for making it to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed making it for you. As always, run tall, run strong, be kind to one another. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time right here on Run Tall with Tim.
If you keep this